present today because I not only represent the youth that are coming into this media climate. And at Columbia College right now, I'm working on a public media 2.0 project that's part of a class. We're bringing attention to key issues that Chicago ends up facing as a result of Renaissance 2010. And I'm a Young People 4 fellow, Young People 4 being a sub-organization of People for the American Way. And as that fellow, I'm creating a blueprint for social justice that will produce an intentional, sustainable, and community-driven project that promotes a vision for social change. So, let's get down to it. What are these problems that I see youth and students at my college experience? Well, few students understand the media landscape and are aware of the way that media consolidation or the big five media corporations create barriers to success in art and media creation, production, and distribution. And they need an education on how corporate media directly impacts society and need to know about some of the battles which have been fought by people like you, media reform and justice activists in the past decades. Only a small amount of students grasp how important art and media is in bringing attention to political, social, and cultural issues and creating conversation on subjects of public significance and in fueling community projects designed to inform or mobilize the public. Students of my generation are digital natives. This generation understands the recent shifts in technology and the culture of creative child developed as a result of the internet. But they do not understand how digital revolutions in media, revolutions spurred by the internet, present a key opportunity to take charge and make significant changes in society. And too many fail to understand the threat that private interests pose to the internet, which has become a bastion of the public commons. I'm unwilling to let students continue to be deluded by this corporate paradigm that is being fed to them, a paradigm which teaches them to go after a job and not consider what they as an artist or media maker can do for society. So, I am setting out to do some kind of an action, and as part of this blueprint that I mentioned, I am organizing an Arts and Media Summit in April 2010 on my campus that will not only speak to some of the problems that we've discussed here today, but will also connect students, hopefully, with people in the Chicago community who are part of this movement. I hope that this summit will invite and educate young artists and media makers of my generation by addressing how artists and media makers can further democratize media in the face of the dominant corporate media structure in society. The value of citizen journalism and participatory media in enhancing publics. The importance of engaging action to preserve an internet. How art and media can spur public action and build community. And the role of artists and media makers in creating public spaces for informed conversation on issues of public significance. I recognize that this endeavor is no small one. I'm creating something that I hope will become not just a part of Columbia College's institution, but a regular event in the city of Chicago, a Midwest conference that activists and others will regularly look forward to each year. Through networking with organizations in Chicago, through working with students, staff, and faculty at Columbia College, and through drawing upon my experiences, I hope students and others in Chicago will be able to learn about the media climate and will be empowered to create art and media which can spur action and enrich their community. My generation must consider the kind of impact we can have in the world, and we must become pioneers for our future. We must shift the power from the few to the many and use media to get closer to a society that values public good over private good. And so I invite you to partner with students from my college and other colleges and make possible an educational event that will open up a broad array of possibilities for the future. Thank you very much.